You're with World News. I'm Don Riddell in London. Now to a trend that's gaining ground around the world. Travelling not for sun and relaxation, but actually to find cheaper medical procedures, a phenomenon known as medical tourism. A 2008 survey puts the market at $60 billion. That's more than 1 million medical tourists, and they're visiting some 35 countries every year. The reason? Huge cost savings. For example, a heart bypass operation in India costs 92% less than the same op in the United States. Indian doctors expect that cost-saving factor to drive more demand for their services. As Sarah Seidner now reports, domestic demand alone is already pushing some to set their sights on higher targets.
Sukhwant Khera's knees were so worn out, every step she took was excruciating.
I was in quite a lot of pain, yes. I had to take a painkiller almost every day.
She decided to get her knees replaced. What she didn't know was she was about to help her doctor break a record.
We didn't actually set off to try and set this record. It just sort of fell into place.
Dr. Ashok Rajgopal is one of the best-known knee surgeons in India. Unbeknownst to most of his patients, Dr. Rajgopal has scheduled 24 knee replacements in just one day. If he succeeded, he would end up breaking a record in India.
We were faced with this rather formidable task of trying to get through 24 knee replacements in an arthroscopy. And
why didn't you just say, no, I can't do all these? This is insane.
We're always up for the challenge, and we wanted to push the envelope.
But pushing the envelope isn't exactly what a patient wants to hear when it comes to medical treatment.
I did think for a while, doesn't he get tired or, you know, fatigued after some time?
Apparently he didn't. He says he and his team finished all the surgeries in 10 hours. In a way, Dr. Rajgopal's record is a metaphor for how India keeps its medical costs so low, even with increasing medical expertise in the country. Those two factors have made India a destination for medical tourism.
It's pretty much the Walmart principle. I mean, you sell more for less. And it's the volume that basically builds up, and over time it equates into the profit margin.
So more and more patients.
Yeah.
But the doctor insists he never compromises the safety of his patients, no matter how many there are. And he expects the floodgates to open as medical tourists from around the world realize what India has to offer. Sarah Seidner, CNN, New Delhi.
Let's take a look at some hotspots for medical tourism. Thailand saw 1.2 million medical visitors in 2006. Costs there averaged 70% less than in the United States. It's home to the largest private hospital in Southeast Asia. India saw 450,000 medical tourists in 2007. Most medical procedures cost 80% less than in the US. Singapore is also working on building a medical hub. 410,000 international patients visited there 3 years ago. Cost their average 65% less than the US. And Malaysia welcomed 300,000 tourists in 2006, mainly for cosmetic surgery and alternative medicine. Costs there are on average three-quarters less than they would be in the United States. It's time for a look at the global weather picture now. Christopher Smith joins